Okay, here we are given a crazy function and we are going to find out its domain. Well, let me just give you guys some quick review first. So here's the first thing. Whenever we have a square root of an expression inside, keep in mind, we will have to make sure that the inside is greater than or equal to 0. That's a restriction when we have square roots. So with that being said, we see that we have this square root of 12 minus x. So that's going to be our first condition. Condition 1, we will have to make sure that 12 minus x is greater than or equal to 0. That's condition 1. But we also have this right here, the 4 plus x instead of the square root. So that's condition 2. Condition 2, we will have to make sure 4 plus x has to be greater than or equal to 0. Alright? So that's what this is for. Next, whenever we have expression, you know, top over bottom, in this case, we have to make sure that the bottom is not equal to 0. Right? This right here, we have to make sure that this is not equal to 0. So if you look at the whole thing, we see that we have what? We have this. The 3 minus the square root of 4 plus x. This is going to be condition 3. I will put it down right here. We will have to make sure 3 minus the square root of 4 plus x. This whole thing cannot be equal to 0. Otherwise, it will be divided by 0. Of course, that's a no good. All right, before I start, let me just tell you. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's so beautiful like that. All right, solve these inequalities and see what happens. Right here, move the 12 to the other side. So negative x is greater than or equal to negative 12. Divide both sides by negative 1. Cancel x. And right here, we get positive 12. But we divide both sides by a negative number. So make sure you remember to switch the inequality symbol. X is less than or equal to 12. Next, 4 plus x is greater than 0. Move the 4 to the other side. X is greater than or equal to negative 4. Condition 1, condition 2, done. Now for this, we have to solve the equation, right? With a not equal sign. Let's put this part right here. Let me just show you guys all the steps. So negative square root of 4 plus x equals negative 3. Divide both sides by negative, we get square root of 4 plus x equals positive 3. So we can proceed. Because square root, the output has to be a non-negative number too. So this right here. It's good. It's 3. It's good. Go ahead, square both sides. Cancel this. We get 4 plus x not equal. It's not equal to 9. Finally, minus the 4 on both sides, the answer is x is not equal to 5. Okay, we have all these three conditions. Now we just have to put them together. This is how I like to do it. From condition 1, let's draw a number line. Here is 12, let me say it's right here. It's inclusive, so close circle, and then it's less than, so we go to the left like this. Use a number line, it's much better for us to visualize. Yeah? Next, we have x is greater than negative 4. So let's say negative 4 is somewhere here. And again, it's inclusive. And then here though, we go to the right like this. All right. Lastly, number 3. Here we have a number line. In fact, the number can be anything except for 5. So let's say line out of 5, let's say it's somewhere right here. And it will just be an open circle because x cannot be equal to 5. But anything else is okay. And the way you do it is you're just shading everything else. Yeah. Now, in order for us to satisfy all these three conditions, we just look for the overlaps, which you can see that right here and also right here. Do not include the 5 though. So the domain for this is that we started at negative 4. Including negative 4, thanks to that closed circle. And then we have to go up to 5. Go up to 5, but not including the 5 because it was punched out earlier, right? Like hole puncher. And then union, we go from 5 to 12. So what do we put down for the 5? Parentheses, good. And what do we put down for the 12? Bracket, good. Yeah, so ladies and gentlemen, this is the domain for that crazy function, and that's how you do it.